It's the most common sexually transmitted disease. About 20 million Americans are currently infected with HPV, and another 6 million people will become infected each year. HPV is so common that at least 50% of sexually active men and women will get it at some point in their lives. So here to tell us more is Dr. Amcam Howie from Iowa Health Des Moines. Thanks for coming in. And what is HPV?
Yeah, HPV, or human papillomavirus, is a virus, as the name implies. There's about 100 different types, about 40 of which are commonly sexually transmitted. Oftentimes you have it, you don't even know you have it, and the hard thing is sometimes you can't predict what kind of outcomes you'll have as a result of being exposed to it.
And it can lead to several diseases, can't it?
Absolutely. So we think of common warts on the hands and the feet. That's not what we're talking about here today. We're talking about those 40. And in men, you can see genital warts. That's the common presentation for men. In women, you can also see genital warts, but also in women, you can see precancer and cancerous lesions develop on parts of their anatomy, such as the vulva, the vagina, as well as on the cervix.
So what can you do to prevent HPV and also all those diseases that it causes?
Yeah, the best thing is prevention. So a couple of things to keep in mind. First and foremost, using condoms. It will prevent transmission from those covered areas, but of course it's not 100%. Second, involve yourself in a monogamous relationship. Limit your number of sexual partners. That makes a huge difference in transmission. For women, great screening test is the pap smear. It doesn't diagnose HPV, but changes that are associated with HPV. So it can help you lead to that diagnosis. And then in men, there's not really any great screening tests. Then the fourth thing to remember is there's a vaccine available called Gardasil, available for both men and women now, young men and women, beginning ages 9 up through the ages of 23. Get it before you're sexually active. It's really one of the only vaccines we have that we know can prevent certain types of cancer, in this case, cervical cancer.
All right, good information, Dr. Amcam Howie. Thank you for coming in. And for more health topics, you can visit our website, kcci.com.